Welcome back. So in this section, let us see page object pattern mechanism. Fine. So till now we have seen how to configure our framework with different kind of external tools like Jenkins for continuous integration and build management. Okay. So we have seen some external tools on top of our framework. But now the basic thing, how to write scripts in an effective way, how to store objects in an effective way. Okay, that is core part. Okay, so if you write a script in such a way that if something changes tomorrow, if that maintenance work is 3 days, then there is no use. For single object change, assume that object you have used in some 500 scripts. If you are not scripted properly, and if you say that I have to update all the 500 scripts because of that object, that is not right mechanism. Okay, that's not right design. So you have to design your scripts in such a way that if there is something change, okay, so you will be updating only at one place so that it should reflect in all the test cases. That's how we will design a framework. The name itself says it's kind of frame. No, we are working to make it an effective way. So there are different types of frameworks available in the market. It's keyword driven, hybrid, data driven, and the now latest, which everyone is adopting for Selenium, is a page object pattern. Okay. So why we are picking page object pattern for our framework design? So the first main reason, it's easy to maintain. Okay. So I'll talk about that. Why it is easy to maintain? I can only tell once I practically show you how the things works with page object. Okay. And easy readability. We also will discuss this, and we can eliminate redundant information as well as reusability of code. Okay. So these are some kind of advantages you get with this page object pattern. And for Selenium, it's suggestible to use this because there's a lot of compatibility, and because everything pattern page object we written in Java kind of classes. Okay, so it will be very benefit if you choose this pattern to design your framework, because keyword driven, hybrid, all these are ruled out now. Those are old fashioned, those are some 20th century kind of frameworks. Because a hybrid framework, you have to depend upon Excel. If Excel crashes, okay, keyword driven, though you have to depend upon Excel. So still you have some data dependency which you take from Excel, but in those kind of hybrid data driven, all the scripts are also driven from Excel sheet, which is not good practice. So let us see where we can actually get benefit from this page object pattern and how to write scripts in this mechanism. Okay, so by parallel teaching, you will slowly realize the importance of this page object, as well as you will get clear explanation for all these points like easy readability, maintain, and reusability. Okay, so let's go ahead and start with our basics of page object pattern, and we can see how we can import top over Selenium code on that. Fine.